For the first time since 2018, when the Leilani Estates eruption occurred, it appears that a significant flank eruption could be imminent at Hawaii's Kilauea volcano. During the last 2 days, approximately 30 million cubic meters of magma has intruded into Kilauea's southwest rift zone, a fairly sizable volume. This magma is seemingly migrating further and further to the southwest every hour while still being above sea level, as indicated by the shifting epicenter of incredibly shallow earthquakes, which has continually shifted in the same direction. Summit tilt meters have reflected this assertion, showing deflation which was last observed during 2018's destructive eruption. Although the presence of magma actively progressing in the direction of the ocean has not been confirmed quite yet, I interpret the slow migration of magma at a rate of 146 meters or 479 feet an hour to be ongoing. Yet, I do not expect a disaster on the same magnitude as the 2018 Leilani Estates eruption to happen if this magma ends up reaching the surface. For one, that eruption occurred in the densely populated East Rift Zone, which contains thousands of structures, while the current activity is occurring in the Southwest Rift Zone, which only has 3 structures. And even these 3 structures are not seemingly at a high risk for an eruption to occur, being located on a small hill and with no recent lava flows having flowed towards it. It is a special time at Kilauea's Southwest Rift Zone, which could produce its first eruption in 50 years. Since 1790, the Southwest Rift Zone has been the less active of the two flank areas, having only erupted 8 times, while the East Rift Zone erupted 11 times in the same time period. Southwest Rift Zone eruptions are somewhat different than those witnessed in the East Rift Zone. They generally erupt at a higher rate per second, providing spectacular scenes, while at the same time are generally less voluminous and shorter in duration than their eastern counterparts. Looking at the statistical average Southwest Rift Zone eruption since 1790, it erupts 17.5 million cubic meters of lava, covers 7.8 square kilometers or 3.01 square miles in molten rock, and lasts a medium of 5 days in length. Here is a quick overview of the 62.39 square kilometers of land, also equal to a square with a length of 4.9 miles, that has been covered by lava in the Southwest Rift Zone since 1790. The largest of these eruptions by volume occurred between 1919 and 1920, erupting a grand total of 40 million cubic meters of lava. Although the current intrusion only involves 30 million cubic meters of lava, this should by all means only be taken into account as a low estimate of what could erupt were an eruption to suddenly begin. As not only could all of this erupt, but also additional material could migrate to any Southwest Rift Zone eruption while it is ongoing. In other words, we may soon witness the largest Kilauea Southwest Rift Zone eruption in historic time. Yet, any eruption would still likely be much smaller than the 1.06 billion cubic meters the 2018 Leilani Estates eruption produced. Despite all of the current excitement for a potential once-in-a-lifetime type voluminous flank eruption, there is still a low double-digit percentage chance that no eruption ends up occurring. Somewhat similar episodes of strong earthquake swarms and magma accumulation occurred in the uppermost section of the Southwest Rift Zone in 2006, 2015, 2021, and October to November of 2023. None of those examples resulted in a Southwest Rift Zone eruption, as the area sort of acts like an additional storage region for magma when the primary central magma chamber of Kilauea is highly pressurized. Although, in my opinion, I believe that a Southwest Rift Zone eruption is now fairly likely, there could still be no eruption at all or a less eventful summit eruption. Regardless, any eruption which occurs is likely to be Kilauea's largest since 2018. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.